Welcome back to Your Stocks on CNBC TV 18. One stock that's in fact flying around is Somany Ceramics. They reported a good set of numbers just a short while back, and we have Mr. Abhishek Somany, the joint MD of Somany Ceramics, who joins us now. Hi, Mr. Somany. Thanks so much for joining in. First things first, top line looks quite good. In fact, could you break that up for us in terms of volume growth as well?
Yes, so the volume growth, if you look at the quarter two, our volume growth is about 9% and the balance is in value terms. And if you look at H1, our volume growth has been more or less 50-50, which is about 12% on volume and about 11-11.5% by value.
Alright, Mr. Somany, just one quick question with regards to the P&L itself. You've seen a good jump up in your other income, though on a low base. It's coming at 2 crores versus 26 lakhs year on year, which has helped your entire profitability despite your margins being flat. Can you just tell us what comprised of the other income and whether that would maybe be sustainable for the remaining quarters as well?
Yes, the other income, there are two parts to it. One is the other operating income, which is scrap sales and all of that, and the rest of it has been net out with the money in the bank, which we raised, the capital which we raised earlier. So yes, it would be sustainable.
Okay.
All right. Mr. Somany, getting back to your operational performance, could you give us some clarity with regard to your other expenses? Because on a year-on-year basis, you had some Forex movement, and because of that, you had booked around 2.5 crores. This time around, is there any kind of Forex element? Because your other expenditure has jumped up close to around 8-9% sequentially, while on a year-on-year basis, it's up close to around 15%.
Correct, but if you look at it, the percentage of sale, our other expenditure hasn't moved up. It's been pretty much flat. And the reason for the absolute increase is that we're spending a lot of more money on branding and brand building.
Right.
So therefore, you'll see a lot more visibility across the board, from exhibitions to television to magazines, etc.
Mr. Somany, getting...
So it's largely that.
Right, just comparing another expenditure with your sales, your power and fuel costs, they have moved absolutely nowhere, though we have seen a big bump up in your sales figure. How do you manage to achieve that?
The power and fuel has not moved up because the dollar has been pretty consistent over the last 6 months. And also the gas prices have moved up very inched up only very little. But like I said, even in my earlier interaction, we're already peaked out on the gas pricing. The rest of it is that our increase in joint ventures, so increase in outsourcing has helped this keep it at base.
Okay. Mr. Somany, can you give us some guidance for the second half as well? For example, what do you think will possibly be a sustainable amount of volume growth that you could clock for the second half of the fiscal? Or what's it looking like in this quarter already, even maybe pre-festive? And secondly, any sort of pricing power that you have in the market at this point?
So the second half generally, overall, every year, whether it's a good or a bad year, the second half is generally better than the first half.
Okay.
That's the first answer. The second one, we're having a lot of capacity which is kicking in within now to January. So we would see a slight increase in the volume growth versus the value growth. Therefore, the volume growth also would be very sustainable. It would only be better. On the other hand, the price increase, I don't think we're going to be seeing any price increase, but we would definitely see more value-added mix coming into the market on a whole. Pre-festive, this year, October, there's Dashera and Diwali, so I don't think October we are expecting very much, but we would make it up in November and December. So overall, it's looking very good.
Just one question before I hand it back to Nigel. You did 12% in the first half of your the fiscal for volume growth. So when you say that second half will be better, you can hike it up to maybe 15% or less or more?
So generally the volume growth is between 60-40, 50-50, depends on which quarter. So this particular quarter we have two plants kicking in, so it might be a little more, but it will average out to somewhere there. So considering we would be growing at 20% CAGR, I think a 60-40, 50-50, hard to tell, so precisely.
All right, Mr. Somany, your stock, in fact, is flying away. It's up closer around 16%. So the market's very happy with your numbers. But one final question, what's your current market share? And you said capacities are coming on stream with good volume growth. What's your market share likely to go up to?
So it's a very fragmented market. So we continuously gain market share, but it's a slow and steady pace. There are 750 manufacturers in India. The industry is extremely fragmented. So from a absolute market share, I don't think there's much to write home about. We are currently at about 13-14% of the organized sector. We would inch up maybe 0.5%, 1%. Like I said, it's super fragmented, the industry.
All right, pleasure talking to you, Mr. Somani. Thanks so much for stopping by and detailing your numbers. Fantastic going, good set of numbers, optimistic about the future as well, and the stock is rewarding all those buyers. In fact, it's up close to around 15% as we speak. But let's get back to answering some of your queries. Sunil calls us from Rajasthan. I think he has investments in Hero Motor Corp. Hi, Sunil.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I have buy.